And our project is on performance analysis of RocksDB and trying to subsequently integrate it into OpenEdX. The objective of the project is in the age of SSDs, what we need to do is reduce the number of writes and as well as reduce the space that is needed by a database. So RocksDB was implemented by built by Facebook for this purpose. Our first objective was to benchmark RocksDB versus InnoDB, which is the current database engine for MySQL. So we have run the test and we have the results. So I'll move on directly to the test results that we saw. InnoDB versus RocksDB. So for InnoDB, we actually ran the test on two virtual machines. Test on an average took us around 3 to 4 hours. It was run using JMeter from a main server onto the other distributed servers. So the test procedure is as follows. We have to set up and tune JMeter. This is the analysis for insert queries. On the left side, you can see that we have the performance analysis for InnoDB, on the right for RocksDB. Since it won't be visible quite properly, I can see it kind of. It is the number of estimated threads versus the number of active transactions.
Number of estimated transactions
taken per second versus the number of active threads at that time. This was run for 1000 queries and with a ramp up time of 100. Like it will take 100 seconds to start 1000 threads.
Which benchmarking software you have used?
We have used Apache JMeter.
It's quite high for RocksDB and low for InnoDB.
Tabulated it. You can see it. Like in insertion queries, the average output is around...
The bias throughput is around 12.5% large for RocksDB. Response latencies is about 10% high. Response latencies is about 10% less for RocksDB. Transaction throughput is about 37% more for RocksDB, and transaction per second is about 20% more for RocksDB.
Just tell me how many features you have tested on?
We have tested the basic queries which are used in any database, like insertion, selection, deletion and updation.
So you tried it with the multiple databases, joints and then indexes?
I'll be focusing on that point. RocksDB is currently not feasible for all systems as well as OpenEdX, because it does not have foreign key nor does it have any equivalent to foreign key. For example, before MySQL 5.5, the default engine was MyISM, and it had full text search instead of this primary key, which is not primary key and foreign key, which was not present at that point. So in InnoDB, primary key and foreign key features were added, and RocksDB it has not been added yet. Neither is full text search available nor spatial search. So currently there is no scope of adding it.
So the all in all, the broad output is that RocksDB is not up to the mark to use.
RocksDB is, sir, can I give a small example? It's one of my favorite examples. Suppose I have to go on an all day Mumbai trip using best buses. I like this example. So there's an all day pass for 70 rupees. I can travel anywhere and everywhere with that, and I have to pay only 70 rupees. But in another case, if I have to go to Hiranandini, I'll prefer buying 2 10 rupees tickets, one from here to there and from there to here back. So it depends on our data set. Like if we have a large number of writes in our database, then RocksDB is preferable because it offers huge compression. Like the database we tested upon on two VMs, the compression was 66%.
Have the stats for that.
Let's assume that RocksDB is better.
What is
your work?
Sir, our work would have been to implement. It was not possible. We have tried every possible way that we could, but it was not possible. And I can promise you this much, that if RocksDB had foreign key, we would have implemented you and given it to you within 10 days. This is a promise, sir. And you can remind me of this anytime you want.
People in Facebook are working for key in RocksDB.
And the thing is that it does not support foreign key.
Now, how exactly the Facebook is using for? Why it is possible for them, and how exactly they are?
Not completely replaced InnoDB by RocksDB in case of storage. They have replaced. Reduces storage up to 50% less in case of RocksDB. So they have not completely removed InnoDB.
But if they didn't have foreign key, even though they store into the RocksDB, how they recover the data?
That data is in a denormalized form, which is present in a particular table. It does not need to be related to some other data.
So the data is being stored into two different databases.
The dumping is being done into the RocksDB and then the sensible data is into the MongoDB. That is present for every database, sir. You can have different database engines for different tables in a database.
I'm talking in context with the Facebook and RocksDB.
It is same, sir, for them also. Okay. They have not completely replaced InnoDB as of yet.
Okay, anything else to tell?
And the tool that we use, it is MariaDB. That is an open source in place replacement for MySQL. The issue arises because the Facebook branch of MySQL, which uses RocksDB, it does not compile. It has this issue since the last 2 or 3 months. So MariaDB has given an in place replacement for that using the RocksDB plugin. So all our tests have been run on MariaDB.
Like the documentation was not updated, so we could not implement MySQL with RocksDB.
What is MariaDB?
Extension of MySQL with more storage engines and more plugins.
Different like options for storage engines.
It has an inbuilt RocksDB engine.
It is same as MySQL.
Yeah, it is just a drop in place replacement for MySQL.
It's just a replica of MySQL.
Queries are all same.
So in 2010, actually, Oracle took over MySQL. So MariaDB came.
That's all, Jiria. Yeah. Any questions, sir, that you may.
Okay, anything else?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. One thing I want to say,
okay,
that anyway we will never use my RocksDB,
okay,
even if it comes with foreign key and all that,
yeah,
okay, because there is no driver, business driver currently,
yeah,
in both NVLI and IIT Bombay X, yeah, to save disk space, okay, it will not be there for another 5 years. After 5 years, we can look at it because we have purchased terabytes of disk, okay, yeah, for NVLI and all. पेटाबाइट करने में पूरा पेट और पीठ एक हो जाएगा, पेटाबाइट नहीं जाएगा।
I have one question, sir, with regard to this. The data storage that you will be using, is it SSD or a hard drive?
SSD.
हाँ, so SSDs have, sir, when you continuously write and read from them, they have a low life expectancy and this can reduce, increase the life expectancy, sir.
There are too many SSDs. They can keep dying. No, it is actually really over on you.
Okay.
That is why I was saying you will not, having a collaborative community, tagging it, etc., it's going to be a decade long process unless you do something automatically.
Yeah.
Okay. Because all these activities are to be done by library folk. They don't get paid to do that. There might be some incentives. Ye karega, wo karega, fir wo, it will be horribly done, then it has to be recorrected. It's a very long process. Complete over engineering. Why? We have got too much disk space, we have got too much computing power space. 5-6 saal tak dekhne ki zarurat nahi. Okay, yeah. Okay, go.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thanks.